right from the beginning of the outbreak, there have been calls for testing, adequate testing. And in that context, finding new cases, we're talking about viral testing using PCR. And that remains the mainstay of case counting around the world in this country as well. And that's the main criteria by which we're assessing where we are with the epidemic. But of course, because both who gets a test and what testing capacity there is very variable and continues to be under capacity in many areas, that is not, we know that that's not really an adequate representation of where we are with the epidemic, because we're missing a lot of cases, either because they're not getting tested because they're mild or asymptomatic, or because there's not sufficient testing capacity even for people with symptoms. And so so there are other indicators that we should be using to try to get a handle on what's going on. Hospitalizations and deaths are more reliable than testing, but of course they're lagged by a couple of weeks at least with respect to the actual infection itself when it occurred. And so we need to start thinking about other proxies for transmission, and that could be things like mobility data, so how people are moving around, and things like that. But really what we want to have as an indicator is something as close to the point of infection as possible, and as closely representative of transmission in the community as possible.